Okay, so it's Saturday morning. I've actually just going to have a tidy up in here. I've actually just put loads of mowers outside and everything else. As you can see, it's just getting a little bit of a mess in here, so I'm just going to have a bit of a tidy up, open my door, move the car, and then just go sweep this garage out. And I'm going to have a look at this this bike, as I've shown you, it's not firing up right. And what I've been waiting for coming in the post is an ultrasonic cleaner. And that has arrived now. This is a James product 9050 Touch professional ultrasonic cleaner. Now, I didn't order this, I actually ordered an 8050. The one I ordered was around £80 and this one's £390 that they've sent me. This is a 7.5 litre with a stainless steel tank. This is a professional ultrasonic cleaner, so I'm not sure what I'm doing with that. I've ordered another one, but I think I'm just going to send this one back, to be honest. I want the one I originally wanted, so just a bit big. So I'm a little bit annoyed, because I've now got a cleaner I wanted to get on and use and start cleaning some of these parts up with, such as this is an old carburetor I've just brought out, and things like that. I mean, I've got one now, but it's not the one I wanted. So at the minute, all I can really do is I'm going to have a tidy up in here. I'm going to sweep all this floor out and get rid of some rubbish, and I'm just going to quickly take the panels off the bike. I probably won't film all that. It's on previous Yamaha Jog videos, is that, but as I've shown in the last few videos, it's still not starting properly, so I'm going to do a few things before I take it to bits. I'm going to set the panels off and try putting a choke on it, and then if that doesn't work, I'm going to try altering the gap where the throttle is and the idle, just seeing if I can do anything to this bike to get it to fire up better without actually having to take any parts off it, just to have a bit of a play around. So if I start just stripping it down and putting loads of bits on it, I won't know which one's made the improvement, so that's what I'm going to do for now. Kind of looks quite funny in here with nothing in it. It's very rarely I take everything out of it, but you see out here I've got stuff everywhere, all down here, and snooker table, and looks like a right Aladdin's cave. But I get a bit tired of it, you know. Once you get in a mess, you really can't be bothered with it. So the one thing I do like on a day like today is, because it's a bit cooler today, it's probably about 3 or 4 degrees, it's not bad outside, to be honest with you, but just out the wind in here. Now I've got this like perspex corrugated thing. It's actually quite like, because there's a lot of natural light, it's kind of still been like outside a lot of the time, and I do like that, so I can just bring stuff in here and I don't feel like I'm stuck indoors so much. So we're going to sweep this out now. I've got a compressor there. Once I've swept it out, I generally just blow it out as well with a compressor. And the only other issue I've got here at the minute is, because I've moved this door, I've actually got a leak. It actually leaks, the water actually leaks in under here, actually gets under this slate. I think it's coming in under here, which is a bit of a pain really, because the rest of the roof now, obviously, if I've done, doesn't leak, unless it rains a lot, which it has done yesterday. Really rained all day. This doesn't happen, and generally it's quite good, but I want to get that sorted. I've actually tried raising this along here as well to stop it coming in. I'm pretty sure it comes in underneath. It's not coming down the door and over the step, because that step slopes outwards. But yeah, I'll brush this out and I'll give it a blast off with this compressor. I'm just going to have another quick go at getting this going before I put it in the garage, just to make sure. I'd rather get it going and take it out and drain, actually use all this fuel that's in the tank. Actually, it's worse than ever. It normally does fire up a little bit, but there's just nothing there at all. It's really struggling. Remember one time I've been riding this, it's the only time it's ever let me down. Well, it didn't let me down, I got it going again. I stopped somewhere because it cut out really strange when I first put it back together. It's never done it since. I just undid the petrol cap and I put it back on. For some reason it started up. I'm not saying that'll work now, but let's give it a go here. Right, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get this bike started. It'll take me about 20 minutes and then I'll film this video again. It's now a good 5 minutes later and I still haven't got this bike started up. So, as you can tell, I'm having loads of bother, and this is why I've not really used it a lot recently, because I got a bit sick of it, so I'll come back in another 5 minutes. I think it's just flooded a bit. And I'll get this going. I'm actually a bit out of breath just from kicking it over. It's only little, but it's that bad to start up at the minute, which is why I want to do these repairs, so I'll give it another go in a minute. I'm eventually getting a few little signs of life from it. Sometimes I'll get to that stage and what I have to do is leave it and it'll eventually, the revs will increase and it'll start running. Increase in a second and this bike will warm up. So they're the problems I'm having getting this bike started up. It's not just from lack of use, because I have used it at least once a week really. It's just recently it's got worse, so I'm just waiting for this bike to pick up a bit. Letting this bike warm up a bit. I'm going to flick it off now. Now it's warmed up to see if it'll start up again. Once the bike's warm, generally starts up again. I've had a few questions on my channel about getting it started again. A few people have got these, not many. Then what I have to do, if I've left it, say if I go in a shop for 5 or 10 minutes and come back out, what I've generally had to do, if I start it on the button like that, it won't start. What I've generally had to do is open the throttle right back and start it up. Because sometimes, if it's still quite warm, you have to try different things. It's an old bike, and actually it's like that. You can't get it going and it'll start for me. Now it's been running for sort of, I don't know, 5 or 6 minutes. It'll generally just, you know, you've not been stopped for long, it'll generally just start up. I want it to be like that control, which is why I bought a choke. I bought another choke to go on the carburetor, because it could be something just as simple as the automatic choke not working. So we'll get these panels off this bike. I'm going to have a brew first, a cup of tea, that is, for anybody not from around here. I'm going to take this bike in the garage now, which is a little bit cleaner. Tidy my bench up, and we'll take these panels off. I'm going to swap this automatic choke over.